Now, audience, I've gotten to know you over the last hour. I've been in you for about an hour or so, and I'm ready to take our relationship to the next level. It's a big thing, it's a big step, but I'm gay. Sorry, Caitlin. And the big part of any gay man's life is when he comes out to his mother. And I did this in the car. I was with my mum, and I was like, "Mum, I have something to tell you." She was like, "What?" I was like, I'm finding it difficult to say. What is it? I'm gay. Oh, thank fuck, I thought you killed someone. Which is kind of reassuring. And it's moments like that when time stops and time becomes another thing. And this happens mostly when you're a kid. And like, when you're a kid and you go up to your parent, like, "Oh, mummy, daddy, I want to go rollerblading or melon hunting or something." And the parent's like, "And so finish my cup of coffee, son." And like, a cup of coffee in real life is about like 10 minutes. But in child time, it's aeons. Civilizations of Lego rise and fall. Generations of Tamagotchi come and go. And then eventually the child returns once the coffee is drank with a Play-Doh beard going, "Mother, father even, all the melons are dead. No one shall taste the taste of melon." And I was like, "What? You're quite weird. Go away. You're free. I love coffee more than you." Big fans of coffee. Yes, throw your children out, just adopt coffee. Don't do that. Oh, what's the time? Yes, but coming out, like I was talking about, coming out is like, it's a big thing, and I love doing it. It's this thing you have to do all through your life. Like, every single time I come out to someone, they get this look on their face, and I love it, because they go, "This person can tell me everything I've ever wanted to know about gay people ever." And they start asking questions. They're like, "Does it hurt? Do you get shit in your dick? Do my shoes go with my jumper? Is my hair very nice? Do you eat rainbows? Do you shit rainbows? Are you made of rainbows?" For the record, it takes 4 rainbows to make a gay person. And a lot of sin. The Pope used to pay me to say that last line, but I don't think I'm going to get paid for that one. And coming out in movies is meant to be this like great liberating, throwing the shackles off of society, "Fuck you, I'm gonna go fuck Hernando," what? Sort of a thing. But in real life it's just sort of, and this happens so much in life, like for example waking up the morning after next to your partner. In like movies you're like, "Oh, good morning, you're beautiful, I'm beautiful, let's have fantastic morning sex, ha ha ha, suck me." Whereas in real life, you wake up more like, "Oh, I can't feel my arm. Oh, you smell. Oh, you don't want sex, do you? I need to poo." And this extends even more into like actual sex. Like, sex in movies is this fantastic, magical thing. Everyone knows where everything's going. The camera cuts, you know what you're doing. But in real life, it's sort of like, wait, if you put your leg that bit. Oh no, that's in my back. Okay, look, if you get on the swing and I'll put on the gimp mask, it's gonna be a lot easier. But yeah, being gay. Gimp mask come up a lot. But like, being gay, I find it very difficult to relate to my heterosexual brothers. And the one thing that binds all men together, whether you're gay, straight, asexual, bisexual, whatever, is pornography. It's the one thing we all know about. And the first time I realised this, it was in Freshers and I was with my flat, we were sitting in the kitchen, and one of the girls pipes up and goes, because she wanted to watch a movie online, going, "Do you think they block any videos that we wanted to watch?" And in unison, every single man went, "No, no, no." Not even the weird stuff. And also this extends further to this sort of strange language of porn that exists. For example, if I say to you, Caitlin, that you're more of an amateur girl, every man will probably get what I mean. I love the slow sort of like, do I admit whether I know or not? And of course you do. but also like I don't get along with like straight guys because I like cock and they like vagina. But also like, I'm quite nerdy and they like sports and that doesn't really fit into the nerdy gay thing. And I try to make the nerdy thing obvious so they don't talk to me, which is why I've got very nerdy glasses. They are real, I'm not a hipster. I do actually need them to be able to read the pretentious things I write on Instagram. But I love them. Like, some people think they're like a burden, but I absolutely love them because they allow you to be incredibly condescending. and get away with it. For example, if someone says something to me like, I think concrete tastes like chocolate, I can just go, really? And it allows you to be really, really crass as well. For example, like, oh, I'd descale her washing machine, if you know what I mean. No one knows what that means. Like, that's not like a common thing you just haven't all got, it's fun. And also, oh, look at my lovely hand I have here. Yes, also, like, as well as being having nerdy glasses, I, like Robin, am a computer scientist. I know this startles you because I'm outside, well, actually I'm inside, but it feels quite large. And like, computer scientists generally don't get out much. They're the kind of people who think, like, living on the edge is unplugging USB stick without safely removing it first. Ooh, my data! They say that every time. In the ECS labs, it's very funny. Oh, my data! but also being a computer scientist, like, I find it incredibly difficult to imagine a world without technology. Like, technology to me is part of everyday life. Like, for example, I really don't know what people did before the mobile phone. Like, I use this every day to avoid people on the street that I don't want to talk to. Every single time I see, like, John coming towards me, if he's here. Oh no, it's John. Oh, what an amusing text. And I really don't know what people did before this. Like, did you have to carry around a letter with you and go, oh, what an amusing correspondence. And on that wonderful note, I'm going to leave you there. I've been talking to you.